Hello and welcome to Let's Read the Books of Beyond Skyrim. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Today we'll be reading Guerilla Warfare, which we found right here in Benuni Alfena's house in Applewatch.
Good morning.
Guerilla Warfare by Adi Machos. The guerrilla tactic of battle is perhaps the most misunderstood and unorthodox type of warfare. It is, however, very common among minor military groups and rebels of all kinds, as well as quite effective if executed correctly. Through my experience as a member of expeditionary forces and my former activity as a military advisor, I will try to present all I can regarding this special kind of warfare. First of all, what exactly is guerrilla? Guerrilla is a hit-and-run type of battle, if I may use this term to describe it. Followers of these tactics harm the enemy with ambushes, sabotages, traps, and generally anything that can prove efficient while avoiding direct contact as much as possible. Of course, it is clear that certain conditions must be met under which an army decides to behave like this. The most usual ones are the following. The size. No leader would engage the enemy in an open battlefield, as is the tradition of war, if his forces are significantly outnumbered. Chances are that the largest enemy will attempt to circle and surround the smaller, thus gaining a very easy victory. To avoid such a pointless loss, a leader must ensure that the battlefield will favor him, since his army's size doesn't. The surroundings. This can determine a lot. If the area in which the fight is to be given is a big field, then it can simply not be guerrilla. It is a usual case of two armies running at each other with unsheathed weapons. If, on the other hand, it is a forest or a canyon, the army that has better knowledge of the place can use it to its advantage and rise victorious against almost anyone. The roll. An attacker usually marches against the opponent with a very well-organized army and is prepared for the worst. A defender may, for several reasons, not be sufficiently powerful to face directly the upcoming danger in a given moment. Instead, he must find the means to deliver the maximum damage while risking minimum losses. Thus, a defending force that is smaller or less powerful, but with good knowledge of the surrounding environment, is more likely to use guerrilla tactics, since this is what will give the best result for such a force. Assuming that at this point the reader is familiar with the causes and reasons that lead one to fight like this, I will now move on to the strategic details. The most important thing in a war is information. Scouts are sent to detect the enemy and gather as many clues as possible regarding his plans, formation, and attack route. When enough information is gathered, the next move is to choose the more suitable place for battle. It is extremely important for a guerrilla fighter to ensure he remains undetected, at least until he launches his attack. If the opposite happens, he will fall victim of his own strategy. As I already mentioned, the place to choose for such an attack must only be one where the larger force cannot move easily and is not familiar with. A good example of the forest of Valenwood or the Fjordas of Morrowind. The guerrilla fighter designs his attack in such a way that his appearance will be sudden and unexpected, and his escape route safe and secure. It's even better if more than one escape route exists to confuse and disorient the enemy. Trapping the escape routes in order to stop the enemies from chasing the attackers is one more common trick in guerrilla. Soon as the plan is decided, the next step is choosing the right tools. Guerrilla fighters prefer, by far, light armor. Fur, leather, chitin, anything that can ensure they move fast and quiet. Enchantments that boost speed and stealth are in order too. The weaponry of these forces usually matches the rest of their equipment. Range weapons, daggers, long swords at most is what these fighters wield. Weapons like spears or claymores reduce speed and add needless weight and are thus regarded as useless. When the mentioned procedures are completed, the time comes to attack. Guerrilla attacks are usually launched at night so that the enemy cannot chase the fleeing attackers into an unknown territory that is covered in darkness. The attack can also take place during daytime, in areas that combine a hard terrain with bad weather conditions. Such places are the Morrowind Ashlands, or the Desert of Alakir, or No Quinal. When the blight storms or sandstorms hit the area, the opponent is usually forced to stay put until it's over, unlike the residents who are conditioned to such situations. Even the forests of Valenwood and Argonia can prove challenging when heavy rain falls or thick mist surrounds them. Only heroes and fools choose to attack amidst such weather at night, since they too risk the possibility of getting disoriented and trapped into their own plan. Finally, the attack. If planned right, it is guaranteed to work with an impressively small amount of casualties. If planned poorly, it is guaranteed to get most of the attackers killed. In this kind of warfare, victory or death is a matter of seconds, and soon as the battle cry is heard, the outcome is determined. It is rather rare for a guerrilla force to choose the annihilation of the enemy as its first objective. More often, the target is the enemy's supplies, be it armor, weapons, food, and in the best case, retrieval of a significant letter. The enemy troops become prey only when exhausted and with broken morale. When this happens, victory is almost assured. The last phase, escaping the battlefield. Needless if the target was the enemy force itself. In any other case, as well as the case of failure, the attackers must flee the area, usually on foot. Through the escape routes, they must outsmart their hunters and save their lives. Once again, it is a matter of proper planning and preparation. Whether the escapees will make it is independent of the attack, but has more chances to succeed if the attack was successful and the enemy's morale broken, and less if the opposite happened. In any case, the guerrilla fighters will attempt to split up a few distance away from the battlefield and hide wherever they can or have planned. It isn't unusual that they drop their equipment to reduce their encumbrance and increase their speed. Trapped routes require extra people who will block the exits or slow down the chasers until their comrades run away. If their presence is noticed, the most likely outcome is jeopardy of the mission, otherwise most will live to fight yet another day. In short, this brief guide to the guerrilla warfare is my contribution to the writer's community. I do hope this will enlighten the reader and increase his understanding of war and warfare. May the Nine keep you safe from these. Thank you for listening to Let's Read the Books of Beyond Skyrim, Guerrilla Warfare.
Sorry, but you need to go. Now. Sorry, but you've got to go. You need to leave. It's time for you to go.